Can you be part of the LGBTQ plus community and convert to Islam?
We had some sort of like a misunderstanding in our last video that we posted about who can convert to Islam. And some people have the idea that if you are part of the LGBTQ plus community, you can convert to Islam, which is not true. In Islam, we don't have discrimination where certain people can convert to Islam and certain people can't. So let's clarify something. That video was about converting to Islam. It was about reverting back to Islam. It's not about what you do once you are Muslim. Secondly, there are two conditions to converting to Islam, and this is something that we need to testify in our Shahada when we're taking our Shahada, our testimony to become Muslim. So in order to become Muslim, we need to believe in one God, and we need to believe that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was his last messenger. Now, once we have that belief, we are Muslim. Even if we do this in the security of our own home, we don't have to like testify in front of a million people. Even if we just do it in our own homes, in our heart even, we are Muslim if we believe those two things. Now, once you are Muslim, we have to follow Islam a certain way. So that's when we're accountable whether we're following something correctly or not. Now, once you are part of the Islamic community, once you're Muslim, there are certain commands that we have to follow. Following certain commands or not, that's up to us. There are certain commands that are impermissible, and then there are commands that are permissible. Now, I have a question for you.
Okay.
Imagine you're not Muslim, right? You're your Islamophobic self. And I tell you, people from the LGBTQ plus community cannot convert to Islam. Mm. How would you feel? Because your uncle is part of that community.
That for me is a very sensitive topic. As I'm sure it is for many of you guys, I feel that's very discriminatory, and I feel like a lot of the comments I'm seeing on that recent video is showing the LGBTQ plus community that like you guys are not welcome no matter what. Like, we have a stigma against you. You are not welcome to convert to Islam, which is completely false, as you mentioned. What happens like before we convert to Islam, if I say I drink alcohol, right, or I'm eating pork, all my sins are wiped when I convert to Islam, right? You're accountable for what happens after you convert to Islam. So I just think it's wrong for people to discriminate and tell people, no, you can't do this, you can't do that, because that's not what you're testifying when you become Muslim. You don't have to be a perfect person when you convert to Islam. So I don't know why there's this stigma that people cannot convert to Islam because of their desires or their sexuality.
One beauty of Islam is that you can be anyone, you can be any walk of life, you can be from any place, and you can still become Muslim.
Now I have a question for you guys. Were there any conditions that you guys thought were required to convert to Islam that you don't actually need to have? Let us know.